Hello and welcome once again to Cities Skylines. My name is James, and the last time we played, we ended up here in the lockdown city, and we've made a couple of cock-ups. What else would you expect? This road down here, very few people have been using it, and I think this is the reason why I have put in these highway roads back to front, so we need to orientate them slightly differently. This one's alright. This one also needs a little bit of help though. So that is one cock-up, and our second cock-up is over here. We have warnings of not enough workers. So somehow we need to enable people to get into this area to work slightly better. And I was playing with paths last episode. I might be able to do that just with paths again. Failing that, we're going to need to get some public transport circulating around this area. But let's start off with the paths, see if that is going to make any difference whatsoever. And as always with paths, I do enjoy not having any guidelines. I think that's connected. I'm going to put another one in over here. Now, can we do any better with this area? We have a connection there. Let's also put that over there. And let's also stick you in there. So, we'll hit play again. We do have demand for industrial and residential. This farmland has still, however, not been built on at all. I wonder if this demand, plus the road fix, will help that in any way, shape, or form. Stick it back on 2-3 speed, because why not? Oh, facility full. Which is fine, we want to empty that eventually anyway. We'll empty it now. I'm just wondering, do we have... we've got incinerators unlocked. Why have we not done that yet? Well, if that's the case, let's pause and empty all of our landfills and start to get some incinerators, which will be much better in the long term. Let's have a look around for where I should place them. Be good if they weren't both stuck right next door to each other. I think for now, well, the traffic's low, we're just going to stick them next to our power plants. We might even push a road further out just to keep them a little bit further away. Doesn't have to be a nice road. Put all of these back on. So this is going to be our spot for all rubbish and incinerators. I said rubbish and incinerators, didn't I? I meant electricity and incinerators. So we've got plenty of money. Let's just pop a good few down. We put in 6, that is all I'm willing to do. Bearing in mind the budget, we do need a little bit of water, seemingly. Down to there. Now, I think it would also be useful to move any and all electricity down to this little grid as well. And the reason for that is just to clear up the rest of the city. So if I go back onto electricity view, anything that I find, We'll move them over. Will I have enough space? I don't quite have enough space. I'll pop them in slightly different. Got one up there, but it is out of the road. That appears to be all for now. Is there any other pylons we don't need? I'm not a big fan of pylons if I don't need them. And we're making enough money, we can pull this electricity power plant over as well. So this is very much a dirty corner of the map. And as a result, I see no reason not to put in some industry. Keep it far away from any houses. And we'll monitor the traffic. There is two ways in and out. So fingers crossed it will not be too bad. We again need to find some more housing. I really don't know what's wrong with this farm, but people don't want to use it. And we have upgraded our park. So, let's add in the extra bits and bobs. What have we we need some water for those too. That's unfortunate. Something I can't see us putting in. But we will throw in the large chest. We're making money with this partner. We're going to see if we can make a little bit more money. Its maintenance is high, so we don't need to worry about that. It's got all the entertainment it needs for its next level. And yes, as we can see, there are people moving in and out fairly regularly. So that is a positive thing. Our residential demand has shot up once again. I think what I'm going to try and do, purely to engage this farm, is build along the highway. I know it's not traditionally what you would do, but we'll put a layer of shops in first as well. And I think this road can cope with another junction. So we will make it a British Road. We shall move this. Follow the curve of the farm round. Like so. And again, sticking with tree lined roads. Straight ones. We are now going to create some access points. Always nice to make your access points before you have to destroy houses, I think. And they can go both ways. There we have the makings. Oh, we have farms. Don't have electricity yet, but that will not be long in coming. Shall link that up like so. And we shall link this up across here. So with the new farmland set, makes sense to get some workers. Oh, we even have some high density. Let's get that in right now. Don't like the way that grid's staggered, but what we're going to do. And we might even pop in Some high density shops. Now, why would you start building up where the power lines are not? City Skylines, you'll never cease to amaze me. Right, sure, we're going to need water as well. And again, cost of 440 keeps me happy. Yeah, I'm going to start building high residential and whatnot in here. I feel we are going to have to give these guys some good services as well. Let's go for big hospital. There's probably overkill, but hoping it'll get the electricity through. And what else do we need? Fire. We could use some fire services over here. Ah, money, however. Money has become a problem once again. And how are our loans? We could take out another loan, let's do so. Yeah, we could definitely use some more fire. Let's put that in over here. Could use a few more jail cells as well. Education is good. High school, not so much. So we are complaining of shortage of workers again. It's only in this lower end. We might be able to fix that with pathing once again. Worth pointing out, as yet, we have not put in any public transport at all. And it may be becoming time. That said, we do need a bit more funding for it. Abandoned buildings over here, but this is also not enough workers. Go away. Yep, that is exactly the case. So I think it is time that we invested in some transport for these people. Start moving people around. And before we decide which transport it is, let's have a wee look at our traffic. It's not too bad, but we do have to be aware of cars in certain areas. And this may also be starting to become a problem. A little roundabout in here might not be the worst case. We still need more housing, which is good, I suppose. We'll be only more willing to put in more housing considering our wind conditions. So, one more layer. Yes, it is only a scenario. We don't need to do too much in terms of the neatness. We just need it to be functional for the foreseeable. So time once again to put in some more housing. We'll go lower density this time. We do need to save up for a high school and public transport. We may get them slightly closer in to our highway. And of course we've got this space here which we can put something. We also have the option now for offices which make good sound barriers, so I can see that happening. What has happened here? We don't want any little shops in there. Where is the door to the hospital? It's on the smaller road. I'm meeting it off just with a path. Make it look like we can approach the hospital from both sides. Come on, work. Come on, there we go. So many things. That looks much better to me. Back exit and front exit. I don't want you there. Need a little bit more water. I do wish there was a better way to toggle those on and off. I know there is a shortcut, I just can't remember it. It has been a long time since I played, and we now need a larger supply of water. Careful not to put this in any polluted areas. And why not use our slightly better sewage treatment. So that has settled all the demand for a small while. And it's possibly time now to think of our transport. We have a main road starting to form out here. Oh, more park pieces once again. An empty facility. That is brilliant news. Let's get rid of you. What am I doing? E for buildables. So if that's empty, have the other two emptied? No, but they are further away. So, in terms of our transport, we have a main road up here and here in a big L shape. We have a main road forming down here, and we could go as far as to have a work line up around here, gets those houses and back in. So what I think that means is we're going to make ourselves a little transport hub. And just to be awkward, I'm going to make that transport hub right here in the middle. So what we need to do is find a spot that's going to be quite noisy anyway. Although I don't want to add to this junction. I'm going to make it... It doesn't have to be a destination, they just have to be able to cross there. I'm going to take this road, pull it out. Okay. We have that. We're going to go to our metros or our undergrounds. And I'm gonna pop in a couple. So as mentioned, we're gonna have an outside loop that comes up the middle, and one that follows this road here. They're all going to meet centrally. It's probably going to be easier if I just lay in some stations to begin with. They're going to go... Oh, stop. Slope too steep. Oh, that's a bit of an odd call there. We might miss out that one. Surely that's not too steep. Well, we are on a bit of a slope, actually. How annoying. Can it go in anywhere? One, two... Can pop that one sideways, and... It's going to accept that. So that's going to be one line. Need to wait on our money to build up before we utilise it, however. Okay, is there any more ways to make some money or improve things? This stage, I am not too sure. We are going to bring electricity over here. I was debating doing that with the park, but again, money is tight. That said, these gazebos are quite cheap. Let's pop a few gazebos into our main park. Dot them around all over the shop. I don't really know what their purpose is meant for in this game, if it's for little performances or just somewhere to sit. But if it increases our park attractiveness, which it has, job done. This park's actually making a lot of money. Over 1,500. What are you? Not enough educated workers. That means we may have to start building more schooling. And that makes absolute sense. Let's build this high school next to one of our stations. In fact, let's put it near the faraway station. That's probably not too far. They'll walk there happily enough, and it'll make everybody happy. But hopefully it being up there means people will use that metro line, and it won't be a waste, and we will get the profitability for it. Meantime, this is a small problem. So, and back to our tree-lined roads. Yes, we do want to take from the node. Go. We should now find this improved. improves ever so slightly. So we do finally want to get this metro line in. Whether I have enough time to do that or not, we will have to wait and see. However, here is more good news. We can get rid of another of those. Makes everyone slightly happier. Happiness isn't too bad, actually, in all sectors. We still have quite a lot of pollution, though, that we'd like to get rid of. This area is nearly clear. Let's get all the industry out of here so when that landfill does go, we are clean. We can put something nice in here next to our transport hub. And hopefully that will make everybody happy. Get some high density housing in here, because why not? In fact, we can make more use of this space. Houses in there. It seems silly not to. There we are. I assume this area is going to be nice. Let's get a few in there too. This is interesting. If I pay these loans and take them out again, I will actually get quite a lot of money. And we're going to now start our tunnel building. Oh, this has changed. Ah, this will give us more money as well. So, some good things unlocked that can make use of in the future. But for now, now we've got that extra 50 grand. Is this how we build tunnels? This has changed with the new update. We don't want overground trams, we want underground metro. They are expensive. Do nicely. It's a rather large gap between those stations, but I'm sure it'll be fine. And it's a rather short gap between those stations, so we will need to monitor that. It might be too small, but we have one line in. Play the game again, take our stops and link them up. And lots of happy faces, that's what we want. So, added in some shops here to make a bit of is add a road here so people can come and drive and turn around easily. We might even get some buses or trams in here, who knows. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we said we would stop there once we got that line in. Next episode we're going to focus on the other two lines of the metro. Population is coming up to a third of the way there. Nope, I'm talking bollocks, but it is rising. All other scenarios look good. So yeah, next episode we'll carry on. Keep building, keep expanding, can make this farm a lot bigger, and we'll continue to transport people from all the areas into all the working spots. So that's all for today. Hope you're well, take care, and goodbye.